Hi everyone, today we are going to study grid and physics waves, question and answers in lesson 4. First of all, we are going to show you people all formula, what we have, symbols, formulas. Just let's explain quickly. In this topic, V equals F times lambda, first formula. V is speed, wave speed, first of all. Let's write wave speed, and then we have, it is in meter per second. What's next, people? F is frequency. Frequency means number of waves in 1 second. Unit is hertz, Hz, or second power of negative one, you can write. Lambda is wavelength. Wavelength in meter. So what else we have, people? T is time for one wave. So frequency is number of waves for one, number of waves in 1 second. And then period is time taken for one wave and unit second. What else we have, people? You see here C, it is constant number, speed of light. And then H is Planck's constant, another constant number we have. And so for speed of light, as you see people, HF or HC over lambda, you can write, because we know F equals C over lambda. So this formula coming from here, people, because you can change V with speed of light, C equals F times lambda, you can write. And then you can say F equals C over lambda, or if you need lambda wavelength, you can write C over F. Another formula you can make from this formula. All formulas and constant numbers here. Let's continue, people, with our questions. Question one. Question one, they said we have two pulses. They're coming to each other. First one amplitude is 3 centimeters. Second one, 8 centimeters, people. When they combine, they are making superposition. What is amplitude? It's easy stuff, people. Just you are gonna add them all. So if you have 8 and 3, superposition, you have, let's see, amplitude equals 8, let's say positive 8 plus positive 3, because you have positive pulse, people. You have positive pulse for 8 centimeters and positive pulse for 3 centimeters. And your answer is 11 centimeters. It is positive. Your pulse is here. This is superposition of pulse. And next, pulse is just single disturbance, people. Single disturbance is pulse, energy coming to particles, particles going up and making pulse. What is next, people? This one, 14 centimeters positive and negative 10 you have. So asking you, when they combine, what is your superposition, amplitude of superposition? You are writing plus 14 and negative 10. When you calculate it, you are getting positive 4. So your superposition result is positive 4. If you have two positive, you are getting more positive, bigger amplitude you are having, people. If you have positive negative, so subtract each other and you are getting, but if you have two negative pulse, and then they are asking you superposition, of course you are gonna get more negative. So it is our question one. Let's continue with other questions. People, when you see question now, before checking answers, before I start, maybe you can just stop video, pause video, and then you can try first and then check solution, please. All right. Let's do that. It's going to be much better for you. You are going to try first. Always I'm telling to my learners, try or die. If you don't try, you cannot learn, people. Just watch this video. You cannot learn like that. First of all, you should try and then you will check answers. All right, please do that. Okay, this is our question now. If 20 cycles of a wave on a rope pass you in 5 seconds, what is the frequency of the wave? This is our question, people. How can we calculate? Let's write all givens first. First of all, they said 20 cycles. This is n, just we are writing n, number of waves, number of cycles, 20. And time is 5 seconds. First of all, write all givens, people. It's gonna be much better, much easier to calculate. Frequency is, we know people, frequency is n over t, because f is frequency, number of waves in 1 second. If you have 20 cycles in 5 seconds, people, if you have 20 cycles in 5 seconds, of course, in 1 second, you have 4, because each second, 4 total, in 5 seconds, 20 cycles. But to calculate it, people, easy way we are using, number of waves over time is giving you frequency. Now let's calculate it, people. F equals number of waves is 20 over 5, and then you are getting 4hz. Unit of frequency is hertz, hz, or you can use 4^-1. This is our answer for question 2, number of waves over time. That's it. Next question is coming now. Next question, question 3. We have position time graph, and then they said calculate wavelength, but we are gonna add something here now. First of all, this distance for all waves, let's write it is for, let's say 12 meters, 12 meters distance till end of this wave. It is just like this, we have 12 meters. If you have 12 meters for all waves, what is wavelength? Wavelength means length of one wave. Okay, length of one wave. They're asking you, people, calculate the wavelength of the wave. Yes, your turn first. Please try. When you try, you are gonna learn, people. Please try this question first. All right, we can answer together now. People, now, first of all, you should get number of waves. Okay, number of waves. Check how many waves we have. People, you have positive pulse and negative pulse making one wave. Okay, positive and negative one. And another one, positive and negative two. You have two waves. Number of waves is two. And then people, we know distance. Let's use D for distance, or X, you can use, it's fine. So D equals, distance equals 12 meters for two waves. And then we are looking for wavelength. Wavelength symbol, you know, we are using this symbol, lambda. Lambda equals distance over N, we can say. Distance is 12, and then number of waves, two, and you are getting 6 meters, done. First of all, you are calculating, you are counting how many waves you have and divide by number of waves, you are getting wavelength for one wave. As you see, people, we have 12 meters total, and then you have two waves. So of course they are sharing and then getting 6 meters each. This is our wavelength, people. Next question is coming now. We are gonna use our graph one more time. Find, they don't say calculate, just find from graph the amplitude of the wave. So amplitude is distance from rest position to highest point. So from rest position to highest point, just you can see on graph, it is given 1 meter. Amplitude is 1 meter. I couldn't give you time, sorry. Anyway, yeah, you pass already, right? So find the amplitude. Amplitude of wave is 1 meter. Just write 1 meter, done. No calculations, nothing. Next question, I will wait for you a few seconds. Okay, so question 5 is coming now. Calculate the frequency of the wave. Okay. Now we are gonna calculate frequency. Please remember question 2, how we calculate frequency, how we calculate, people. Frequency equals number of waves over time. In this question, as you see, people, time is given 4 seconds. Let's write time equals 4 seconds for all waves. Number of waves we calculate already in question four, three. We calculate already the number of waves. As you see, one, positive, negative making one, positive, negative making two. We have two waves. And frequency equals number of waves over time. Number of waves is 2, time is 4 seconds. Your answer is 0.5 Hz. Or you can write 0.5 × −1. I hope it is clear, people. What are we doing, people, here? First of all, you are counting how many waves we have. Positive, negative one, positive, negative two, number of waves you are writing down. And then time you are getting from table, from position time graph. From positive position time graph, you are getting time. And number of waves over time equals frequency 0.5. It means, people, every second, half wave is coming. As you see on graph also, you see, people, every second from 0 to 1, half wave. From 1 to 2, another half, just like that, 0.5 waves in 1 second. Frequency means number of waves. You know already that. Let's continue with next question. Question 6 coming now. Calculate the period of the wave. So what was it, people? Period is time taken for one wave. Okay, please try. This is your question. Please try number 6 now. All right, now we are answering our question 6. Question 6, let's see, people. Number 6. Same problem, same thing we are doing, people. First of all, you are just counting number of waves. Number of waves we calculate, we count already in other question. It was 2, and then time, it is given 4 seconds. So formula, capital T, period equals time over N. Frequency, what was it? N over T, but now T over N we are using, people. Time over number of waves. So time is 4, number of waves 2, and you are getting 2 seconds. This is our answer, people, for time taken for one wave is 2 seconds. As you see, people, on graph directly, you can say also, if you don't want to calculate directly from graph, you can say, as you see, people, period, just start wave starting from here, half and one, as you see, people, 2 seconds. You can say 2 seconds directly from our position time graph also. We have done this question also. Let's continue with question 7. Calculate the speed of the wave. Now, speed of the wave, we are gonna calculate, people, for this graph. One more time, we are using our position time graph. Please try. Okay, I don't wait for you because I know you are gonna pause video and then you are gonna try. After that, because I don't know how long it will take for you to calculate this question. All right, so let's continue, people. Calculate speed of the wave. One more time, let's write what we know. We know number of waves equals 2, and then time is 4 seconds. And then we calculate our frequency, it was 0.5 Hz, and period is 2 seconds. We calculate all, we know all. And what we know, people, first formula, speed equals frequency times lambda, wavelength. Wavelength also we calculate. What was the wavelength, people? It was 12 total and then 6 meters wavelength. F times lambda, first formula. So V equals, F is 0.5 times 6. And then you are getting 3 meters per second. It is our first option to calculate speed. Second option is V equals lambda over t you can write, because we know f equals 1 over t, people, just opposite each other. Do you remember f was n over t, and then period equals t over n, so we can write f equals 1 over t or t equals 1 over f. Now we are using from f to 1 over t. So lambda, it was 6 meters over 2 seconds, and you are getting 3 meters per second. I hope you are getting it, people. Not so quick. So slowly, slowly we can explain, but the easy ones, people, just calculate the speed of the wave. We are just calculating like this. We have two options. Option one is here by using frequency and wavelength. Option one, and then option two. These are two options to calculate speed. And we are going to next question. Now question eight, there's no more position time graph. Calculate the frequency of wave with a speed of 8 meters per second and wavelength of 100 millimeters. This is your question. Good luck, please try. Yes, now we can carry on with solution. Let's write all given, people. V equals 8 meters per second, and wavelength equals 100 millimeters. So we must convert it to meter, divide by 1000. So you can write 0.1 meter. You are just converting wavelength from millimeter to meter. Now, formula. What was our formula, people? Speed equals frequency times wavelength. And from this formula, we can write F equals V over lambda. And the V is 8, as you see. And then wavelength is 0.1. You are getting 80 Hz, or we said you can write also 80^-1. This is our frequency. So maybe they can ask you, people, calculate period also. Period is 1/f. They can add more questions, but this question 8 we have done. Let's continue with next question, number 9 now. Wavelength is 150 meters. Let's write, okay. Wavelength is 150 meters and the frequency is 0.038 Hz. Calculate the speed. First of all, people, your turn, you are gonna try. Now we are trying, people. Wavelength equals 150 meters. Frequency is 0.038 Hz. All right, let's carry on. Wavelength is 150 meters. Frequency is 0.0 Hz when we are looking for speed. Speed equals frequency times wavelength, and 150 times 0.03, and you are getting 4.5 meters per second. This is our answer for question 9. Let's continue with next question. Okay, now question 10. Calculate the frequency of radio waves with wavelength of 5 kilometers. This is your question. Please try. You can use our constant numbers and formula, people. Okay, we are answering now. Calculate the frequency of wavelength. For this question, people, we are using speed of light. C equals F times lambda, because we know already, people, it was V. V equals F times lambda. Now you are changing speed of light with V, and they are asking you people frequency, so you can write F equals C over lambda. First of all, we are writing formula. Let's write all givens. gives only wavelength. Wavelength equals 5 kilometers and 5,000 meters. 5,000 meters. Why we are converting it, people? Because wavelength is supposed to be in meter, because speed of light in meter per second. Now we can calculate it, people. 3 × 10⁸ over 5,000. When you calculate it, people, you are gonna get 6 × 10⁴ Hz. So we are using our formula and getting answer, people. Let's go to next question, number 11. Frequency of radiation in microwave is 2.45 GHz. So these units we should know, people. We can make our list. For example, if you have 1 GH, if you have 1 GHz equals 1 × 10⁹ billion. It means billion G. If you see G, people, just write 10⁹. And the next one, if just make MHz, megahertz, 1 × 10⁵. Now 6. So G changed to 10⁹, M changed to 10⁵. And the next one, kilohertz, just like kilometer. So now change to 10⁻³,000 hertz, just like that, people. In small numbers now, if you have 1 MHz, how can we convert it, people? 1 × 10⁻³ Hz. And then if you have 1 µH, so 1 × 10⁻⁶ divided by million now. And then we have another one, nano, n, now small n we are using, 1 × 10⁻⁹. If you want, you can carry on. We have another one, PHZ, pico, 1 × 10⁻½. So all units here, for some questions we are gonna use it, people. Now, but we have GHZ, so your frequency is F equals 2.45 GHz. It means 2.45 × 10⁹. We are writing, just remember G is 10⁹ Hz. And we are looking for wavelength. What was our formula, people? C equals F times lambda. So wavelength equals C over frequency, you can write. C is 3 × 10⁸. It is constant number you can get from formula box. And then people, F is 2.45 × 10⁹. And then we are calculating it, people. Let's use our calculator and let's calculate it. What we have, 3 × 10⁸. Eight divided by and then divide 3 × 10⁸ over 2.45 × 10⁹. And what are we getting, people? 0.12 meters. 0.12 meters. This is our answer, people. Wavelength, how we are calculating. I hope it is clear. We should remember these units, people, this important point. We must just convert to our units. If you need meter, just convert to meter. If you need Hz, convert to Hz. Next question, question 12 now. Calculate the energy of a red light ray with a wavelength of 700 nm. You remember what was the nm? Okay, just remember those units. Okay, your turn, please try. Now let's write all givens, what is given here, and then we can answer together. Wavelength is given, people, 700 nm. What we said, people, if you see nm, you are writing 10⁻⁹ meters. If you want, you can just write like this, 7 times 10 to the power of negative 7 meters. And then we are looking for energy. Energy formula is E equals H times F, our first formula from formula box, but F is not given. So we can write another formula with wavelength, H C over lambda. If you want, people, you can calculate F first by using this formula, C over lambda, but that long way, we don't need to use it. You can get F first and you can calculate F and then you can get energy, or directly use this formula, E equals H times C over lambda. And E equals, H is what? It is constant number from formula box. You can get it, people. Times 10 to the power of 6.63 times 10 to the power of negative 3, 4. And then C is constant number, speed of light, 3 times 10 to the power of 8 over lambda is 7 times 10 to the power of negative 7. This is our solution, people. It's calculated. And then you are getting answer, people. So answer is 2.84 times 10 to power of negative 19 joules, because unit of energy, joules. This is our question 12. It is our last question for today, people. See you next lesson. I hope you are getting it. We have done. Thank you very much. See you next lesson, people.